morning and welcome back to the channel. This morning, we're out in Vernon County and we have a morning light effect. And I happen to be set up on top of this ridge, outlooking a beautiful valley. And I have a great rustic barn in the foreground. And I'm gonna get started on a painting today. This is one of my favorite places to paint. I've never painted it under morning light. It's very hazy right now. It's almost not even sunny. I think the sun might break through the clouds a little bit in a few minutes. And once that happens, I'll start to mix my colors and really get this painting started. I've got my canvas set up. I'm in a great location. I'm happy to be here. And it's time to start painting. Okay, from where I'm standing, I'm looking at this scene through these fruit trees. It's kind of nice because I myself, I'm out of the shade a little bit, but it's kind of obscuring the subject matter slightly. So as I'm painting this, just keep that in mind. I'm looking through some foliage at this scene. I've got the big shapes of dark and light placed. The next step is to mix some of these colors that are going to showcase that morning light. The woman who lives on the farm, her dad actually lived just like 2 miles away from me. I'm like 45 or 50 minutes away from the farm, and it's just a really small world because she is an Astel, and Ray Astel lives just kitty corner from me on the farm, and that's her uncle, and her dad lived just down the road about a mile or two away. So small world, you never know who you're gonna see. And again, you know, the thing that we talked about again was that, oh, glad you're painting it because, you know, you never know, it's not going to be here forever. Well, this is where I'm leaving this one for today. I never really got the light that I really wanted this morning, but I think I have a really nice start on this painting. And I'm gonna come back on another day, another morning light condition, and I'm gonna add a lot of sparkle and color to this painting. And in the painting so far, I've really held back in adding in a lot of the color and drama and feeling of morning light. I'm thinking that on the next day that I come back, I'm gonna wait for just a really beautiful morning. But for today, I've kind of nailed things down. I've got things where they're gonna be. I've worked a little bit on some different areas, but overall the humidity in the air is kind of, it's almost like a cloudy effect today. But anyway, wrapping this one up, looks like I got somebody stopping to talk here. We'll be back on another day. We'll see you in the next session. Well, it's 8:30 in the morning and we're back here for day two. Honestly, I would have loved to have gotten up here earlier, but there's so much haze in the air. There's so much atmosphere. And I think it's partially due to the wildfires that are unfortunately happening right now. Also, it's just summer morning light, so it's probably some humidity in the air. I don't really know what it is, but I'm gonna paint it. And that's always how it goes, is that you just observe whatever you're seeing, and that's what you paint. At least that's what I do. Oh, it's just a beautiful morning. I've had a little bit of time this morning. I woke up at 6:30. I went for a half hour walk with the dogs. I did my legs workout, and then I drove 45 minutes to get over here, and it's still early. So even though I destroyed my ankle skateboarding 3 weeks ago, I'm still getting my leg workout in so that I can maintain my strength and, you know, get back on the skateboard whenever that happens. And the legs also really helps when you're standing outside painting all day. I was accidentally filming on video mode on my GoPro instead of the time-lapse mode or the time warp mode. The memory card ended up being full and I had to erase that portion because not only am I working on this painting today, but I have another one going on down the road and I wanted to have enough storage space to do so. So I didn't actually film everything that was going on. The GoPro kind of does what it wants, and this is the GoPro's world and I'm just living in it. But I did finish the painting. There's something to finishing the painting even though the filming wasn't going on. As you can see, you know, I'm looking through kind of this foliage here, and it would have been a better idea if I would have got up in front of it, but I was kind of in the shade and I thought that this was kind of a nice place to sit. And this is the painting that I came up with. Super happy with the quality of morning light that I was able to capture in this one. I'm gonna put my signature on it. We've got a lot of mist rising in the hills behind the barn. We've got that yellow sky. You can kind of see the sunshine just shimmering down the sky onto the landscape. And of course that barn, because it's backlit, takes on a dark purple cast. The horses behind me are neighing, and I think I'm ready to head down the road and finish the next painting off that I'm working on today. Well, the sun came out and I'm perched up here in between a cornfield and the highway. I kind of found a higher view so that I could paint a view of this valley and that trout stream and that good-looking rustic barn that's in the foreground, which will end up being the centerpiece of it all. But this is the second painting that I'm working on today. I'm just looking to get this painting blocked in this morning. I'm looking to get the main shapes placed in on this morning, and then I'll come back on another sunny day and finish it off. Love painting out here in Vernon County. It's all these rolling hills and these valleys and these old barns. I was out painting around here yesterday, and the boys who are working down there, they work for a trucking company and they have beef cattle and everything else. And I said, you know, you guys mind if I paint around here? They said, we don't give a shit. Do whatever you want. So I like that attitude. So I feel kind of comfortable up here, trucking company. A lot of times there's big rigs flying down these roads, and that wasn't a big rig, but it kind of sounded like it. All right, I'm gonna set these things up. Hopefully I'll just work for an hour, get out of here. I got some more things to do today. Let's get this painting started. All right, the first session is done. I worked on it for an hour today. I got things set up. I got things placed how I wanted them. So they're just the big shapes right now. It's almost like you could take some construction paper and some scissors and just cut these big shapes out of paper. And that's my preferred way of painting, is to have those big shapes. Big shapes, when you walk into a gallery or a studio and you see a painting with big shapes, it just jumps out at you, and that's what I'm trying to do here. The colors today, you know, it's really pretty humid out today. It's going to be a high of 85 or 90 today, and there's a lot of humidity in the air. It's almost overcast even though it's sunny, and it's been like that most days recently. So I'm going to come back here and I'm going to finish this one off when we got a pure crisp quality of sun, or at least that's what I'd like to do. I can't plan what the weather does, and I don't really want to plan what the weather does either. For today's session, we're out of here. I'm gonna go talk to an Amish cabinet maker about making some frames for me, but we'll definitely get back out here and finish this one off in the near future. Major update. I've made friends with the farmers out there. The guy, Ira, he's a young guy. He is living on his grandparents' old place down there. He's got some cattle over there, and he's got a great looking farm. Actually, it's a farm that I painted yesterday. He just took me on a ride on his UTV up to the top of this ridge, and it's exactly what I want to paint.
I think I'm gonna be, you know, now I'm just like, I gotta finish these paintings off before I can get out there and start those paintings. I think morning light, it's gonna be awesome. I think late light, golden hour situation, it's gonna be great. You know, he just pulled up and he asked if I wanted to hop in his UTV and go for a ride and go check out the view from the top of the ridge. And, you know, it was majorly worth it. It's probably one of the best scenes I've ever encountered, and that's what it's like out here in Vernon County.
All right, we're back here working on this painting of that barn, and I get to walk all my things up this little path and set up for the painting session. All right, the GoPro died on me. Like I said, I was recording too much earlier. Finishing off this painting. So two paintings today out here in Vernon County. In this painting, I've got a lot of those kind of puffball clouds that are happening up there, and there's a lot of atmosphere, and there's all the color of the summer day. Here we've got a little trout stream going back behind the barn, and of course that barn is just kind of towering over this valley, and that's the type of thing that I like painting most. You know, I've always felt like this, the month of August, is one of the best months to paint. You've got all of the grasses are long. Obviously I'm standing amongst a bunch of weeds and grasses here, and everything is so long and the colors are so interesting. A lot of times people are curious about how to paint the color green. Well, it's like, if you can see all of the other colors that are influencing the color green, then really, I mean, green is the least of your worries, because everything is just a really interesting shade of green. Maybe it's leaning more orange because the grasses are long and burnt off. Maybe there's an area of dirt that's exposed between the grass and the sun is falling on it and it becomes really an ochre color. There's all kinds of purple weeds out in that field today. There's all kinds of things happening. I'm never really afraid of the color green because I just paint what I see and it seems to work out. So I'm gonna wrap this one up. I can see two things I wanna change now that I'm looking at it through the camera lens, but I'm packing my things up. Corbin and I are leaving for a 5 or 6 day camping trip in the van, so I'm sure we'll see you on the next one.